And with us now is Lou Engle. He's the co-founder of the Call Prayer Movement aimed at bringing revival to America. Why is this perhaps an even more important time for a call to prayer for our nation?
I think the greatest crisis is not a time to despair. America's in its greatest time of crisis. It's not a time for despair because historic awakenings and revivals always come in the darkest hour. And I think it's time for the church to believe that God is going to demonstrate his glory in the difficulty of this moment with the race riots, the racism that's being revealed in the nation and all. Everything's up in the air, but God's got an answer, and it's the unity of the body of Christ uniting in an Acts chapter 2 kind of where they were all together in one place. That was the miracle of Pentecost. It's the miracle of Azusa Street 109 years ago, where a black man, William Seymour, led this nation into an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. We're believing it's gonna happen again. Come on.
Well, you're gearing up for a call Azusa Street in April of next year. And you feel like this, what's leading you to have a call there?
Well, I go back years ago when I moved to Pasadena. I was praying for revival. I read a book called Azusa Street by this man, Frank Bartleman, who is an intercessor for that revival. It lit me on fire. It was a burning book, not a burning bush, but a burning book. And one night I cried, give me the mantle of Frank Bartleman. I don't want to read about revival. I want to see it. And I cried out to God. And the next day a guy walks up to me and says, I had a dream last night. In this dream, I saw this big black book. The title said Revival. And then he said, I turned the inside of the cover. I saw a guy's face. His name was Frank Bartleman, and his face turned to your face, Lou. For 30 years, I've been praying that God would release an Azusa Street revival to unite the races and the outpouring of the Spirit in a third great awakening. This is now coming into the 110th anniversary, and I'm on a storyline, and I'm believing for it.
And for those who don't remember Azusa Street, I mean, we weren't alive, but it was happening in L.A., in the Pasadena area,
in 1906. Yes.
And a very powerful move of God, but you believe that what we're going to see there is going to be even more powerful.
I was at doing the call Berkeley, and I was praying, and I was saying, God, you know, we need a great awakening. And I was fasting with about 70 young people who were fasting and praying for 40 days. Mm-hmm. And the Lord spoke to me, call the leader of the Azusa Street organization, African American. He and I had kind of a disagreement 6 years ago. I get reconciled to him on the phone, and he says to me, Lou, the call Azusa Street is waiting for you. The next day I'm praying, God, do you want me to do this? And the thought comes, look up April 9th, 2016, 110th anniversary of the Azusa Street Revival, where black and white were united together. Mm. It's a Saturday. That's what the Lord said to me. I look it up. It's a Saturday. So I call my friend Chris Berglund, who's been a prophet to me. Mm. And I said, I told him this thing. And he said, Lou, do you remember my dream that I had during January of 2013 when we were fasting? No, I don't remember. In the dream, he says, I received five sets of five plane tickets, and the only airline we could fly in is United. We had to fly United. I think God's saying it's time for the church to unite.
Lou, you're always so inspiring, and we feel like we just want to pray when you come to visit us. Thank you so much.
I love you guys so much. Wendy, you've been such an encouragement to me. Thank you.